In the 1940s, radio programs reflected the war efforts and provided updates to citizens. In addition, radio programs like Amos and Andy and the Judy Canova Show provided much-needed relief to families. However, one show rose above them all to entertain America.
It's a bird.
It's a plane.
It's Superman. Yes, it's Superman. Strange visitor from another planet who came to Earth with powers and abilities far beyond those of mortal men. Superman.
While excited children sat on the edge of their seats to listen to the adventures of the Man of Steel, war, poverty, and the Ku Klux Klan were trying to destroy America. However, the KKK had never met a hero like Stetson Kennedy. He became their newest member and biggest foe. Kennedy began working with the Georgia Bureau of Investigation under the fake identity of John Perkins. He participated in meetings and turned over the evidence in hopes of prosecuting members. However, Kennedy wanted to take things a step further. He contacted the writers of the Superman radio show with a plan and a mission. Together, they developed a 16-part episode story arc, Clan of the Fiery Cross. Kennedy shared his findings with Drew Pearson, a writer for the Washington Post and producer of the radio show Superman. Pearson was also a member of the Anti-Defamation League. A powerful plot was written, revealing the inner workings of the KKK meetings. As a result, many secrets, including handshakes, rituals, passwords, and meeting locations, were revealed. Before the Superman storyline, the number of members within the KKK had skyrocketed. The hateful group tried to use the Bible and local laws to express their need for growing power and values. According to the Vintage News, using inside data supplied by Kennedy, Pearson broadcast coast to coast every Sunday. The minutes of the Klansmen's last meeting, including the roll call name, the names of the sheriffs, police, chieftains, public officials, and businessmen who had been in attendance, they were all revealed. The reputation of the KKK declined, and they were hit with a monetary loss from which they have never been able to recover. While the 1940s radio broadcast of Superman may have the credit for exposing the KKK, Stetson Kennedy and Drew Pearson are the true heroes of this story. Kennedy said, "The Bedsheet Brigade is bad enough, but the real threat to Americans and human rights today is the plainclothes klucks in the halls of government and certain black-robed klucks on court benches." Stetson soon became the target for attacks. His life was threatened, his house was burned, and a $1,000 bounty was placed on his head by Sam Green, who at that time was a Grand Dragon of the KKK. The threats did not stop Stetson. According to Adam Woodward of Little White Lies, Sam Green never had to pay the reward. Despite the best efforts of the Klan to discover their mole, Kennedy escaped detection until 1951 when he blew his cover by testifying against the Klan before a federal grand jury investigating bomb attacks aimed at Black, Catholic, and Jewish centers. Stetson continued to fight for human rights until his death at the age of 94 in 2011.